Did you crop a photo and end up losing quality? Save it with AI. Howdy everyone, hope all is well. In this video, we're gonna show you how Zoner Studio can help you with something called AI Resize. Imagine you crop a photo, but now it's too small and the quality isn't great. Thanks to the new AI features in Zoner Studio, you now have two ways to enlarge it again. Now, the method you choose is gonna depend on what photo you have and how big you need it to be. The first method is AI Resize using Reconstructive Interpolation. It enlarges the photo without inventing new details, giving you a natural looking result with no distortion. This method is very fast and works great for batches of photos, but don't overdo it. It's best when you're enlarging up to about double the original size. For example, if you had to crop a photo, but you want to keep the original pixel dimensions. So say for example, if you had to crop a photo, but you want to keep the original pixel dimensions. You can find this resize option in the batch filter and export or in the editor module under edit. I'm gonna show you how to use it in export. Scroll down to AI Resize and choose the method. Reconstructive interpolation is selected by default. I have the same photo resized using AI Reconstructive Interpolation and the original method that was in Zoner Studio. When I zoom in on both, the difference in quality is as clear as day. Now let's take a look at the second method, Generative Resize. This method uses AI to fill in the details when the image is enlarged significantly. In practice, it figures out what's hidden in blurred areas and either adds clarity to the texture or smooths those areas out. Simply put, it doesn't just stretch the photo, it actually enhances its content. You can find Generative Resize in the editor module under Edit or in the batch filter with the shortcut Control Q. Click Add Filter and choose AI Resize. Under Method, you can see both new options. Now, I wanna emphasize this. If you're working with batch files, just remember, it's going to overwrite your files. So it's much better to have some kind of backup or create copies of the original. Now back to resizing. Generative resize is meant for dramatic enlargements, 4 times or more, where regular resizing methods are just not enough. It's great for small images or photos that were significantly reduced. Keep in mind though, the generative method adds details based on its own calibrations. This can lead to a loss of original detail and texture. So if you want to keep the original sharpness and texture, reconstructive interpolation is going to be your better option. Also, generative resize can take longer because it's computationally more intensive. Resize your photos using AI naturally and without compromising any of your image quality. And if you haven't had a chance yet, try out Zoner Studio for free for 7 days and you'll find a link in the description. Otherwise, give us a thumbs up. Don't forget to hit the notification bell so you never miss another video, and have a good one. Ciao.